Hello everyone, in this lecture we will derive uncertainty commutator relation and we will use the Schwarz inequality to derive this relation. So let's begin the today's lecture. Humne last ke lecture mein uncertainty operator nikala tha jo ki a or expectation value of a ki equal tha similarly for b. If you want to see this, how we derive this relation, how do we get this uncertainty operator, you can watch the previous lecture video. So we are having this uncertainty operators. So first of all, we will see whether these operators are Hermitian or not, Hermitian or anti-Hermitian. So let's start with delta A. So if we take the adjoint of this uncertainty operator, then we just have to open the delta A operator and then take the adjoint. So we can take the individual adjoint and delta A adjoint. Since the operator A is Hermitian, then its adjoint should be equal to A and its expectation value is purely real. So since it is a real value, its adjoint will be same as its original value, and this adjoint is equal to original adjoint operator, and this we can write this as same. So what is this? The original uncertainty operator, we have started with this and end with this, so it is an Hermitian operator. Similarly, we can find for the delta B. So our uncertainty operators are Hermitian in nature. So let's get to next topic. So we will read Schwarz inequality first and then derive the relation. What is Schwarz inequality? So if we have any state psi and any state phi, then if we take the scalar product with itself of both the state and take the product, then this product should be more than or equal to the scalar product of psi with phi and then magnitude square. So this is the Schwarz inequality. So let's begin with our derivation part. So let's assume two states xi, which is equal to uncertainty operator operating on another state, and then phi, where delta, another operator, uncertainty operator operating on psi. So these are two operators, and then we have to apply the Schwarz inequality. So we get, so we first have to find out the xi xi and then phi phi. So here we get psi, we have to take the adjoint because we have reversed the this is ket, and then we have taken the brass, so we have to take the adjoint operator and then ket. And then similarly we can write this for phi delta b adjoint delta b and then psi. So this can be, since delta is an Hermitian operator, so we can write its adjoint as simple a. So we can square it out. So we can write this as square of delta a and then psi. So we can shorten this with delta a square expectation value. So similarly we can write this for psi delta b square, because delta b is also Hermitian operator, and psi, and shorten it to delta b whole square. So these are two relations, and we another one we have to find out the xi with phi. So we get xi is equal to psi delta a adjoint, and then phi is delta b operator operating on psi. So we can write this as delta a because it is a Hermitian operator. Then we can shorten it with this delta a and delta b. So now we can write this whole equation using Schwarz inequality, which is equal to, we'll get delta a square expectation value and the expectation value of delta b square, which should be greater than or equal to magnitude of delta a b and its magnitude square. So we derive this using Schwarz inequality. So now we have to simplify this product of operators. So we can write this as half of delta a b commutator plus half anti commutator delta a comma delta b. So if you open these, we get this delta a into delta b. So we have to find the commutator of delta a and delta b. So just opening the brackets and then b delta a. So we have to further open the single operators. We get a b minus a b expectation, a expectation b, and then a b expectation. Similarly for b a and then b a minus b a, and then since it is a constant, so we can cancel out these things. So we get, if you open the minus bracket and then changes the sign, so this will cancel with this. Since it is a constant, so there is no problem of order a, and then a with b, this whole will cancel out. We are left with these two terms, which is equal to a b minus b a. So this is equal to commutator of AB. So this is equal to commutator of A and B. So we will make use of it and see next. So let's write the equations. So delta A square expectation and delta B square expectation is more than equal to expectation value of delta A delta B magnitude square, and we know delta A into delta B can be written as half sum of delta A commutator delta B and then addition half anti commutator of these two operators, and we also know the commutator of delta A and delta B is equal to commutator of A and B. So we just have to put this in this equation. So we get delta A delta B is equal to half AB plus half delta A delta B anticommutator. So we have to put this relation into here. So before that, we have to take the expectation value of this whole thing and then square. So we have to take the expectation value and take the square of this. So we get delta A delta B and then square is equal to 1 by 4 delta AB square magnitude square plus 1 by 4 the expectation value of delta anticommutator whole square magnitude. So we know that this delta AB is a Hermitian operator. And this is anti-Hermitian. So this part is Hermitian, so its value is real. It's anti-Hermitian, so its value is imaginary. So it is a combination of real and imaginary. So we can write this as, so we get this relation. Here this part is Hermitian and this part is anti-Hermitian, so its expectation value is real and its value is imaginary. So it's a combination of real and imaginary. So we can write this as this term, this real term is always less than this whole combination. So we can infer from it that the expectation value of the product of uncertainty operators is more than or equal to 1 by 4 times the expectation value of the commutator A and B and the magnitude square. So delta A square expectation value and then delta B square expectation value should be greater than or equal to the product of expectation value and its magnitude square. Comparing these two, we get that delta expectation value delta A square and expectation value B square is more than or equal to 1 by 4 times delta A B square. So we finally get this expression by comparing these the previous two equations. So we can take the square root of this and we simply get the product of two uncertainty operators more than or equal to 1 by 2 times A B commutator, its expectation value and its magnitude. So this is the relation commutator relation of operators with uncertainty operators. So this is it for today. If you have any doubts, you can write me in the comment box. And thank you for watching this video.